This is a Kahan TV sports break. We're going to have a discussion today. I got Vlad Kitajczyk in the studio. It's been a while since we checked in with him and thought it'd be a good time. It's January now. He's back from his vacation. You have a good vacation, Vlad?
Tremendous. Yeah. Fun. It was fun as always.
I'm glad. Well, we're back to business now. We got to talk about the NBA. All right. We're into January now, this long, long, long regular season. You're our resident NBA expert. You follow the Lakers also pretty closely. So we're going to talk about the Lakers for our first segment. They had a good start to the season, then they had injuries, and they started struggling. Mm-hmm. And now they fell completely out of the playoff race. I don't even think Laker fans would say that they're anywhere gonna be having any chance to be making the playoffs, so that's out of the question. But let's start with first question: what exactly happened? What was the reason they fell out of the playoffs? And we know they had a little injuries. When they got players back, though, they still seemed to struggle.
Right.
Talk about that for a sec.
Initially it was injuries. Injuries to Julius Randle, D'Angelo Russell. But after those guys came back, still the same problems. Bad shot selection, no defense. These things have cost them all season, and it's continuing to cost them every game. They take bad shots, no execution, long threes that just have no chance of going in most nights. If they continue to play this way, they're going to lose a lot of games this season. But, I mean, this is a young team. They're going to grow. Hopefully they're going to, learn from this experience, which has been tough. No one will deny. This last month was a disaster. They were, last we talked, I think they were 10-11, 10-12, something like that. They were right there.
They were right in the hunt. They were a game back of the playoffs, something like that.
And now it just, it's a free fall. They just went all the way down. They're right there in the bottom 3-4 teams in the Western Conference. And, they will be okay. They have a young group here. They have guys that can play this game. I trust Luke Walton. I think he's a good coach. It just depends on the talent. These young guys, what are they going to be going forward? Is Ingram going to be a star player? What's Russell going to do? How good is Randle? These are questions that are left to say. Do they have a superstar that could carry them up currently? If not, could they trade one of these young players for a star player that's disgruntled? A Cousins, a Paul George. I don't know. There's something out there for them, but we just have to see how it goes. Because, yes, this has been a bad month for them, but they will recover in the long run. They'll be okay.
That's what I was going to say. Because no Laker fan was really expecting this team to make the playoffs. Once they got to a hot start, expectations elevated a little bit. People were thinking that they should make the playoffs or they should at least be in the hunt. What are the good signs you see? You mentioned the young players. What are you seeing in the development of some of these young guys, particularly Brandon Ingram, who's a rookie and who's been contributing massively off the bench? He looks like he belongs. He doesn't look afraid, and he looks like he shows up to play. And that's been a bright spot, in my opinion. But who are the players that you mentioned can maybe be used as chips for trade, or who would you want to keep? Who do you really think should be on this team in the future if they're going to be a playoff team?
Julius Randle, outside of maybe having a lack of defense, but really, this is the current NBA. Nobody plays a lot of great defense, so he's a great player. He can do a lot of things for you.
You like Randle?
I do.
You want to keep him as your starter? You think he could be a starting player on a winning team?
Yes. With the right players around him, yes. As if he has to do the majority of the work, no, that won't get it done. But he's a good player. He can hit the outside shot. He drives the lane well. He rebounds. He passes. He's a good player. He could be a great player on a team that has other very good players around him. So, yes.
What about D'Angelo Russell? If you were the general manager of the Lakers, at this point we've seen him for a year and a half. Right. Would you want to keep him, or do you think he's going to be trade bait?
I would look to see if there is what kind of interest there is for him, honestly. Not that he's not, I think he actually is a skilled player. He can hit the outside shot, he passes the ball well, all these things. But yeah, I would look to see if anybody's interested, what they would be willing to give to get Russell, who's still a young player and could easily grow into become a very skilled point guard in this league. I just don't see any superstar potential in him now, like I do with Ingram, who I think is just this close. He just needs a couple, two good years. He has all the tools, the athleticism, the length. just needs to put on some weight, be in the weight room, lifting weights. Once that happens, once you know, once he gets stronger, the sky's the limit for him. He could be one of the best young players in the league going forward. But of course, that it's too early to say that now because you know he's had some bad bad stretches this season as well. But like I said, he's a rookie. He's one of the youngest players in the whole league. We'll see how it goes going forward. But as far as physical tools, it's all there. So we'll just have to see how he develops as going forward.
All right, one last thing before we wrap up this Lakers segment. They're at 14-26 now. We're about 40 games in, about halfway. Mm. It looks like they're going to end up around somewhere around that 30-win mark, which is maybe a little bit above expectations or what people expected. But as Laker fans, what do Laker fans want to see for this last half of the season? As someone flings the door open here at Kahan's TV Studios. Yeah, we're shooting right in the middle of a segment and someone walks in. It's okay. But okay, so what do Laker fans want to see going forward? And what would be positive for this team for the last half of the season?
I mean, just to see the growth of these young players. Clarkson, Russell, Ingram. Just to see Larry Nance when he comes back. Just to see how they develop, how they perform. I mean, I also want to see like improvement, defensively, because you have to play defense eventually. You can't just rely on hitting the outside shot, and scoring. It's good to be able to, have ball movement, score the ball, things like that, but you have to play defense. And they have to, there's no reason for an athletic team like this not to be able to, because they have athletes on this team. It's just about effort and practice and knowing what you're doing on certain, in certain situations like pick and roll or when you're switching, what are you doing? And that's been really bad. I mean, they give up, how many points did they give up? Over 110 points. Ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Well, I'm going to hold you right there. I'm going to stop you right there because defense has been a hot button issue in the NBA. Mm-hmm. And we're going to talk about that a little bit later in one of our upcoming segments. So we're going to hold on to that. It's not just the Lakers who have defensive struggles. A lot of teams have defensive struggles.
This is true.
And we're going to talk about whether that's because of the style of the league right now or if teams are just really bad at playing defense. But we're going to have a discussion about that. So that's all we're going to talk about for the Lakers today. They're basically done. But we covered them early in the season. They were a good story. They had a hot start, and they have a young, exciting team with a lot of nice, talented players. And they were a story. They're not anymore. We're not gonna probably talk about them as much as the season goes along. But that's all for now. We'll be back in a moment with another sports break.